Have welcomed you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, lesson number 16. The topic it is internal land forming processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain the different types of volcanicity and also state the features that are extrusive features. Let's get started. Already, we said that there are two types of features that result from volcanicity. One of them, it is extrusive landforms and the intrusive landforms. Let's start by looking at the extrusive landforms. Now, when we talk about the extrusive landforms, they are the features that are formed on the earth surface. So the magma must become the lava. And remember, we say lava, it is when it gets to the earth surface, since magma will lose the gas. Another thing that you're supposed to know, there are two ways in which volcanic materials, that is magma, reach the earth surface. It can get to the earth surface either through a vent or a pipe or through a fissure. Or this one, it is the crack. Now, let us have a look at these features. The ones that are formed when the magma gets its way to the earth surface through a vent. These features are volcano features. That is one. Eruption through a vent results in material piling up to build a cone-shaped hill called a volcano. Volcanoes built around one vent are referred to as central volcanoes. So you can have more than one volcano in one vent. And that is the reason as to why we refer to them as the central volcano. They are built of lava or the pyroclast or a mixture of the two. When we talk about the pyroclast, it involves the dust and also the dust. We have the dust and other materials that are not lava. Now, they vary greatly in size, shape, steepness of their slopes, depending on whether the injected material is acidic or basaltic. Remember, we said there are three types of magma, and the major ones is acidic and basaltic. Let us see what is the difference. When we talk about the basalt, is a basic lava with low silica content. It is therefore of low viscosity. Those are the characteristics. That means that cooling and condensation will take place where it moves very far from the vent, meaning that it will form a gentle sloping volcano. Acidic lava, which is of high viscosity, high silica content, result to the formation or cooling and condensing near the vent, thus steep slopes. Then we also have crater, is the central depression at the central volcanoes. As a point where now we have the central volcanoes. We have that central part where the vent is. It results to the formation of a crater. It represents the upper end of the vent. Types of volcanoes. Already you have said volcanoes are one of the features, extrusive features, but there are three types of volcano. One of them, it is extinct volcano. For the extinct volcano, they don't show any signs of volcanic activity in history times, they don't show that sign. An example, we have Mount Edgon and Mount Kenya. Dormant volcanoes. These are those mountains which are not active but show signs of volcanic activity. So they are not active, but they show the sign of activity. Examples are Mount Kilimanjaro, Longonot, and Menengai. Then we have the active volcano. They are volcanoes that show current volcanic activity. They have erupted in the near future. And an example, we have Ondonyo Lengai. This is in Tanzania. Then in Ethiopia, we have Mount Kameru. This mountain, they have a history of eruption. They have erupted in near future. That is the reason why they are referred to as the active volcanoes. Number two, we have the basic or the basaltic lava or shield domes. This is the central volcano with a very wide gentle sloping cone. That is an indicator the material that was used to form it was basic lava. This is due to its low viscosity, to springs and froze for a long distance before it cools and undens. When it cools and solidifies, it builds up a broad, gentle sloping volcanic dome. And it is very wide in proportion to its height. The angle of the slope are quite low, hence the name shield volcanoes. And an example, we have Mount Meru. This is in Ethiopia, Mount Simien, which is still in Ethiopia, and Mount Marsabit. This is in Kenya. You can be able to see how the lava dome shape looks like. You can see steep side dome shape, building dome crater, the rising magma where the vent is, and then you can be able to see it. Number three, we have the acidic lava cones. For the acidic lava is viscous. It builds high volcanic cones since it does not spread over wide area but goes close to the vent. It results into the steep-sided slope. And an example, we have Mount Kenya, Mount Kilimanjaro, Mount Suswa, Menengai, and Ondonyo Lengai. Let us see the image. It looks like that. That how acidic lava looks like. We also have the complex cones, that is the stratified and parasite. Vent type of eruption can build simple cones, in the sense that repeated eruption can cause stratified cones with successive layers of ash, cinder, and magma. Sometimes the vent branches result in the formation of parasitic cones. And an example, we have Mount Longonot. Let us see the image. That's the way it looks like. You can see the side vent and where the parasitic hills are, parasitic mountain are. Activity for today. With an end of diagram, differentiate between an acidic lava dome and the basaltic lava dome volcanoes. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2, third edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us either USMS to us, you can also get us through the YouTube, you can also get us in the Facebook, You can also